Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies for one. Lesson number 23, the topic it is entrepreneurship. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our business lesson goals today. We are going to explain the factors that might lead to the business success and look at the ethical issues in a business. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to state the factors that lead to business success. Number two, the learner should also be able to state the ethical issues in a business. We start by looking at the factors that result to the success of the business, causes of business success. One, it is the ability of manage people. So this is the point where now we have the manager of the business. The manager of the business should be readily available and also apply the skills that are there to be used in the management of the business. So it should be available, the management sector. Number two, a proper location, availability of the customers. When you properly locate your business near to your customers, you are going to get that your business advances or your business grows very fast. Number three, availability of raw materials or stock of goods. This is the point where now you say that when you start selling a commodity or dealing with a certain commodity, certain raw material, it is readily available throughout the year. So it means that there is no time when that commodity won't be available. If at all you are dealing with a fruit vendor, there are those fruits that are in season and out of season. But now you get that for the time when it is out of season, you can be able to replace it with another fruit that is in season. And in that case, that in your stock, there is no time when you are going to say that I'm dealing with mangoes, I'll open up the business once again when mangoes are going to be in season. Number four, it is adequate finance. Starting a business requires a lot of finance, capital, investing, since of even ensuring that the commodities are readily available when they are required. Number five, lack of competition. This is the point where now you lack the competition. There is no stiff competition that you are facing, or no other businesses that have been started in the area that are similar to yours. So in that case, now you lack the competition. You are the only boss. So in that case, now you get that you are growing very fast. Number six, commitment to the business. How are you committed to the business? How are you committed to the business? Are you there? Or you're just leaving people to learn your business without you getting committed? Number seven, it is the proper management of the finances. Yes, you have the manager who is managing your business, but there is the proper handling of the finances. Are they good? Number eight, it is proper debt management. Number nine, good public relations. You should be having that good rapport with your client, with your customers. Then number 10, being creative and innovative. Let us look at the ethical issues in a business. When we talk about the ethical issues in a business, it refers to a set of values and principles which influence how individuals, groups of people and society in general behave. How do they behave? Integrity, their moral, their principles, their honesty, their fairness, responsibility, conscience, choice, honor, value. What do they honor? So we look at all that in the business. Business ethics help business unit in deciding what actions are right and wrong depending on the circumstances. So you look at the ethics. Need for the ethical issues in the business. What are the need? One, ensures non-discrimination in business. So you don't look at some people as they have no value in your business. Other people, they have a value. Don't discriminate. Even if that person is the first time to come and get things from you, then don't discriminate. Don't show that person is not of importance to you. Number two, it creates fairness in competition. So there is that fairness in the competition. Number three, ensures protection of the environment. So the environment is protected. It is not destroyed like the one that you can be able to see. So you protect that environment to ensure that it is good. Number four, it ensures the rights of employees are upheld. So you ensure that the rights of the employees are upheld. The rights of the employees have the rights. So you ensure that they are reserved. It helps in avoiding environmental degradation. This is a point where now you can be able to see the environment, it is too dirty. So after doing the ethics, you can be able to see the student there or the people who are working that place, they are trying to remove the dumping, the garbage, they are correcting it. So in this case now it helps in avoiding environmental degradation. Next, avoids consumer exploitation. This is a point where now the consumers are protected. Next, eliminate use of unfair means of achieving business objectives. So you don't use the unfair ones. Assignments. Explain the role of ethics in business operation. Number two, explain the various types of pollution. If at all you want to get the reference, get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 1, that edition. If at all you have any additional information, any question, you can get us through the SMSing. You can also get us from the YouTube, from the Facebook, and also you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to EdimTV. Thank you.